was watching this Christmas program on YouTube on TV, and there was Liberty University on the side of the street on the front of the building, and a beautiful orchestra choir of families, which is incredible. And at one point, this year, the School of Music stood up and sang some songs, and it kind of really inspired the Christmas program.
Now, is this the
Thank you. a good shepherd. You know, it's one thing to have peace with your coach, it's a whole thing. Or peace with your teacher, whatever it is for you. But you know, it's more than that. Well, guys, I'm going to give you, I'm not going to give you that thing. I'm going to give you peace even with your enemy. Go first to him and give peace with him. Why do we do this? Put our way to the Lord. So what is the way in which we can see to please the Lord? Because if we choose those ways, then we choose your peace. Amen? Okay, and so here's what I want you to do. Here's two things. Number one, you can write this down. Love the Word of God.
Right? So,
told you, how can we be certain that this gift is a gift from God that we can come with? As we're trying to live our own, we can raise the things of it. But we can maybe some of our ways that we're working on it, but how do we know that this gift will keep us alive? How do we know that God loves some of those gifts that we get that we're going to make so much better than God?
Thank you.
So I don't know what it is when we get to that crisis that we don't really fall into Christ and we're running out the direction of the day, but we play with the rules bitterly and we justify all the principles that are associated with the rules bitterly and sorrow and anger, and we sound more like Job's wife than Job's. Job's wife said, "Well, if you curse God, you're dead."
There is a noise of wonder, there is a
130, verse 5 and 7 says this, I wait for the Lord, my soul waits. And in his word, I hope my soul waits for the Lord more than the watchman for the morning, more than the watchman for the morning. Oh, Israel, hope in the Lord. For with the Lord, there is this place for us. And with him, it's plentiful. Not in my skills and talents and abilities, not in my networking capabilities, but in his word. He made a choice that he said, in your word I will hope. All of Israel is told in this verse right here, hope in the Lord. And now I see the Lord kind of grasping us in, didn't he? Is that what it says? The Gentiles would praise him for the mercy of God. You need to put your hope into the word of God. So listen to me. The choice that you need to make when you have a crisis of faith, when hope seems like it's nowhere around, you put your hope in the word of God. You begin to praise him. You begin to praise him, and you put your hope in the word of God. How long do you need? You do it. Just get the breakthrough, not breakdown. Just hear me. He's calling for the breakthrough, not breakdown. You might get broken in the process. But you'll make the case. We have to make the development. I never think my hope would be deferred by my life. It's meant expected to grow your career and character to be changed. for each other. You have no idea some of the chaos that some people sit in your seats and don't do. Some of you are sitting next to a miracle. It's a miracle that you're going to do. And it's miracles that aren't in this world today. So I pray that you're here the next time we gather for the time of God. But this is what we need to cling to this life, because he promised to be faithful. What do you confess to me? Start confessing the things that aren't even real. Just confess them. I just confess that love was going to come to me. And I believe that life is going to change. I believe that I'm in this relationship. I believe that I'm here with faith in Jesus. I believe that the first thing we're doing right now is Jesus. Come on, somebody. I just believe that this is just my way for a miracle. I'm going to preach that. in that. That's where we'll talk about that. Lord, where are the things that we're talking about? The gift of children. And we'll open that up and see that wonderful presence. But for today, I want you to see something that we are opening scripture in. It says this, that if God fulfills you with all joy and peace of believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. It is incredibly good. I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace. Because you trust in Him, because you trust in Him. And then you will overflow, don't say overflow. The power of the Holy Spirit. And so today, as I worship Him, prepare us to say, lead us in a moment of worship.